As part of a stats project, a teacher brings a bag of marbles containing 600 white marbles and 400 red marbles. She tells the students the bag contains 1,000 total marbles and asks her students to determine how many red marbles are in the bag without counting them. A student randomly draws 200 marbles from the bag. Of the 200 marbles, 85 are red. So based upon this sample of 200 marbles, the student would estimate that how many marbles in the bag were red. Well, because 85 out of 200 marbles from the sample were red, the fraction of marbles that were red were 85 200ths. And notice how this fraction does simplify. There's a common factor of 5 between 85 and 200. So if we divide both the numerator and denominator by 5, 85 divided by 5 is equal to 17, 200 divided by 5 is equal to 40. So if this is a fraction of red marbles from the sample, the student would also estimate that this fraction of marbles would be red from the total of 1,000 marbles. But let's also write this fraction as a percentage. To convert a fraction to a percentage, we first convert to a decimal by dividing, then convert the decimal to a percentage. So to convert 17/40 to a decimal, we would have 17 divided by 40, which gives us 0.425. To convert a decimal to a percentage, we can move the decimal point to the right two places and add a percent sign, or multiply by 100 and add a percent sign. So 17/40 is equal to 42.5%. So again, as a decimal, we had 0.425, which is equal to 42.5%. So we can also say that the student would estimate that 42.5% of the total 1,000 marbles would be red. So we can pose this question two ways. We could answer the question, what is 17/40 of 1,000? Again, there are a total of 1,000 marbles. We could also answer the question, what is 42.5% of 1,000. Let's answer both of these questions, and then we'll also look at this a third way by setting up a proportion. In mathematics, of means multiplication, so in order to find 17/40 of 1,000, we want to find the product of 17/40 and 1,000. In order to find the percent of a number, we convert the percent to a decimal and multiply. So to find 42.5% of 1,000, because 42.5% as a decimal is 0.425, we want to find 0.425 times 1,000 to find 42.5% of 1,000. We'll notice here, because we're multiplying by 1,000, we could just move the decimal point to the right three places and find our product. But let's go ahead and check both of these on the calculator. So for 17/40 times 1,000, I'd probably put the fraction in parentheses. So there's 17/40 and then times 1,000, which is equal to 425. And notice how 0.425 times 1,000 will give us the same result, 425. So this would be the student's estimate for the total number of red marbles out of the 1,000 marbles. Notice how this is actually just an estimate, because we already know, or at least the teacher knows, there are only 400 red marbles out of the 1,000. Now let's take a look at this a third way by setting up a proportion. A proportion is formed when we set two ratios or rates equal to each other. So for this first ratio, using the sample, we know 85 out of 200 marbles are red. So here we're comparing the red marbles to the sample size, and we'd estimate this would be equal to the number of red marbles out of the total of 1,000 marbles. So the second ratio would be R, the unknown red marbles, to the total of 1,000 marbles. So this is our proportion, and now to solve the proportion, we would cross multiply and solve for R. So to cross multiply, we'd have 200 times R must equal 85 times 1,000. Well, 200 times R is 200R equals 85 times 1,000 would be 85,000. And now to solve for r, we would divide both sides by 200. Simplifying, we have r equals 85,000 divided by 200 is, again, 425. So as you can see, there are several ways to solve this type of problem. I hope you found this helpful.